Hi everyone, it's Vicky here and welcome to the third day of my week featuring Averiel stamps. Today I'm going to use this beautiful stamp set which is called Retro Ornaments. There are also matching dies for this stamp set and it's full of beautiful ornaments as well as tree branches, little stars, a bow and many more little elements to create your lovely scene. And I thought that since these are retro designs, it would be perfect to match them with pattern papers from this pattern paper collection by Tim Holtz. So I have chosen a few and I am going to create my card bases out of this dark chocolate cardstock. So I'm going to cut it and fold it to be a standard card that's 4.25 by 5.5. I have chosen to work with the round ornament as my focal point, which I am going to stamp it 4 times with Versamark ink. And since everything is retro looking, I won't be using white embossing powder, but vanilla instead. So this is vanilla colored. I am going to use my heat gun to heat set it. And I am also going to stamp 2 more times on the red pattern paper. Now the idea is to create 2 identical ornaments and just to make them more interesting, I have stamped them in red and green because I am going to do some paper piecing. Today I'm going to show you how you can create a spinner card, and to do so you need to end up with 2 identical pieces. If you want, you can do as I am doing, paper piecing, or you can just stamp and color your ornaments as long as you end up with 2 identical ones. So now I'm going to use the die that was included in the set and I'm going to cut the red ones. I'm using my C6 machine and I had to pass it twice since there is only 1 die for the round ornament. So now I have both my ornaments there, and just to make them more interesting, I'm just going to cut out with my scissors the inside of the ornaments out of the green pattern paper. I will use some tape adhesive at the back of the green pattern paper and I'm going to stick on top of the ornament. And I'm going to repeat the same process for both those ornaments so I end up with 2 identical ones. Now as I'm doing that, just to remind you that there is a full list of all the supplies that I'm using today just below the video in the description area as well as on my blog. Also there are 2 giveaways running on my blog right now. One is for one Averiel stamp set and the other one is for the October Card Kit by Simon Says Stamp. So make sure to visit my blog and enter your details if you haven't done so already. I am also adding some glitter with my Clear Wink of Stella glitter pen because ornaments just have to be shiny. And you can see that I can stick them back to back and they match perfectly. Now I need to find a round die that fits those ornaments. So this is the one I'm going to use to create the window for my spinner card. I have cut out this beautiful pattern paper by Tim Holtz to be slightly smaller than my standard card and I'm going to secure it with some repositional tape on top of my card base. Notice that I haven't sticked down the paper. Now I'm going to place the die on top and I'm going to pass it through my C6 machine. So with one pass I am going to cut out both the pattern paper and my card base. Also notice that I have opened up my card base, so I'm cutting only a hole on the front panel of the card base. I'm going to show you what I mean here. I'm going to remove the die. And you can see that I can separate the paper from the card base. And now I have to stick those ornaments back to back. To do so, I am going to use my Xyron machine and this is going to turn them into stickers. But if you don't have this, you can always use your tape adhesive at the back. And in any case, just make sure that you use some strong adhesive so that they stack together nicely. If you are using your Xyron machine, make sure to go all around it with your bone folder just to make sure that all that glue is separated. And now I can peel off my ornaments. They are nice and sticky at the back. Now to create your spinner card, you will need some type of thread. I am using this golden thread just because it's about Christmas and I think a touch of gold in this retro colored card is going to look perfect. So I'm sticking it at the back. and I'm going to cover it up with the other ornament. So I have sandwiched the thread inside from top to bottom. And this is going to spin all around in my card. Now all I have to do now is to add some tape adhesive at the back of my panel. I'm going to make sure that I go all over the outside as well as the inside around the hole there. And now I'm going to stick down the ornament at the center of the hole. Also make sure that the hole that you have opened on your panel and your card base is big enough for your ornament to spin around easily. And also, just to make sure that everything is nicely secured there, I am adding an extra piece of tape. I am using my scissors to cut off the excess thread, and now I am ready to stick that panel directly on top of my card base. Now I am making sure that I match those holes perfectly. I have used those dies, one inside the other, to create this ring. This comes from the same pattern paper collection as the rest of the papers. And I am going to stick that around the hole that I have on my card. I think that this is going to help that ornament pop even more against the background. And now to embellish my card even more, I am going to use this pattern paper and I'm going to stamp on top one of the branches that is available in the stamp set. I am going to show you which one it is. I'm going to stamp it with Versamark ink and I'm going to apply some green embossing powder. The embossing powder that I'm using is by Wow, and I think that that color matches perfectly the card. You can also just stamp with any green ink pad that you have, if you don't have green embossing powder. In the stamp set there is also an adorable bow, which I am going to use to embellish my card too. So I am going to stamp that on top of red pattern paper. I'm just browsing through those papers to choose just a tiny little spot to stamp the bow. I am going to white emboss it this time, so that it's more visible once I have applied the embossing powder and cut it out. Now for both the branches and the bow, I'm going to use the matching dies that are available in the set to cut everything out. So I have all my die cuts ready to go now. I'm going to use some foam tape at the back of the branches to help them pop a little bit more, and that's Ginger, who decided that those branches were really interesting. So anyway, I am going to add those foam tapes at the back and I'm going to stick them on top of my ornament, and this way I'm going to create a nice little cluster at the top with the two branches and the bow. Just make sure that as you stick those down, you don't block the spinning of the ornament. And now my main card is pretty much finished. All that's left to do is to add the sentiment. I chose one of the sentiments and I embossed it at the very bottom of my card. I used the same vanilla embossing powder that I did use on the ornament. Now I'm going to show you a nice trick to make a great surprise. Before you put it inside the envelope, just make sure that you spin it many, many times. Hold it like that and place it inside the envelope. Once the recipient gets the card and opens the flap, the ornament will start spinning. And that was the card for today. I hope you had fun and got inspired. And if you did, don't forget to leave me a comment as well as give me thumbs up on my YouTube channel. Don't forget to visit my blog and enter the giveaways. And also visit me tomorrow for another card featuring Averiel stamps. And if you need more inspiration, here are two more videos where I am featuring Averiel stamps, which are actually day 1 and day 2 from this week. Thank you all for watching.